the Pulse Network. It's social TV.
Time now for our Captain Comeback segment here on Cold Hard Football Facts on TPN. I'm Butch Stearns of the Pulse Network, joined alongside, as always, by Kerry Byrne of Cold Hard Football Facts. Captain Comeback, tell people about Scott.
What he does. Scott Kazmar is one of our great contributors. We call him Captain Comeback because he writes our Captain Comeback column. This guy is probably, in fact, he does have the greatest database of comebacks and game-winning drives throughout history, to the point, Butch, that he corrects NFL teams and NFL networks when they have it wrong, because he has a complete list. And a really entertaining writer. And this week, this month, he wrote about the butterfly effect of Tim Tebow had never become the starter in Denver. And it goes beyond just, you know, reinvigorating Denver's season. That was a bad team and obviously went to the playoffs. It's almost like, you remember the old movie, It's a Wonderful Life, and George Bailey, if he didn't do this, it was kind of the ripple effect throughout life. And so we kind of look at that, what would have happened.
So let's talk about the premise that Scott writes about with Tim Tebow and how he's changed NFL history. And let's look at the domino effect. And you go back to week four of last NFL season, and then we'll go to week 14. Explain what this is all about.
Week four, Kyle Orton's the quarterback of the Broncos, right? They go to play the mighty Green Bay Packers, the defending Super Bowl champs. What happens? Kyle Orton has a bad day, throws three picks, the Packers win in a rout. It was one of the games that actually, you know, put the ball in motion for Tim Tebow to become quarterback. You know, and then the Packers destroyed the Broncos that day. What happens? Tim Tebow becomes starting quarterback. They have to get rid of Kyle Orton. They can't keep him around. He ends up with the Chiefs. Plays the Packers later in the season. The only quarterback in the AFC to play the Packers twice last year. What happened in that second game? He hands the Packers their only loss of the season.
So Kyle Orton's performance against the Packers, which was so bad, makes Denver start Tebow. Tebow goes on that run. Orton goes to the Chiefs. He beats the Packers. Yep. The domino effect continues here.
The domino effect continues because what we want to know
the
is...
The butterfly effect.
The Packers, if they weren't playing a guy who had already seen their defense, and Kyle Orton, he played much better the second time. He had over 100 passer rating, zero picks after having three the first time he faced the Packers. If the Packers win that game against the lowly Chiefs, remember they were big favorites, Aaron Rodgers and all the starters probably play in Week 17 so the Packers can chase an undefeated season. They're not rusty going into the Giants game. We're talking quite possibly, this is an 18-0 team going into the Super Bowl.
Right.
Not to play the Patriots, but to play the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Interesting.
And the reason being because
Denver beat the Steelers in the playoffs.
Denver beat
the butterfly effect.
The butterfly effect now. So the Broncos win the AFC West, right, kind of unexpectedly from out of nowhere, going on that great run. If the Pittsburgh could play somewhere else against San Diego's the AFC champion, Ryan Clark, because he has that sickle cell problem, the Steelers safety, couldn't play in Denver. The only place he couldn't play, that defense is probably a lot better. Tim Tebow doesn't abuse that pass defense. And we're talking undefeated Packers in a repeat Super Bowl against the Steelers.
Well, and not only that, but now you're talking about the Packers at the end. Don't go for the undefeated season because Kyle Orton wins. Matt Flynn gets to play. Matt Flynn gets a big contract. Again, part of the Tebow butterfly effect. Yep. If Tebow doesn't start, if Orton doesn't get beat up like that, maybe Matt Flynn never gets a chance to play.
And not only did he play well, he had probably the greatest passing day in Packers history in Week 17, right? He wouldn't have played if they were going for the undefeated season. Gets a big contract in Seattle. And honestly, it's a lot of fun, this piece. It's got a lot of cool numbers in it. And you really do wonder. You can do it for a lot of different things in football history. You wonder what might have been if Tim Tebow had never gone on that run he went on.
His name is Scott Kazmar. The column is called Captain Comeback. You can find it on Cold Hard Football Facts. This one is about the butterfly effect of how Tim Tebow changed the NFL and changed NFL history. Let me read you one of his comments, Scott's in this, and let's finish this segment with this. Not only, says Scott, was Tim Tebow the biggest story of the 2011 season, but he's the centerpiece for shaping the NFL's next several years. We sort of just documented all that, but explain further what he's talking about.
Because the NFL is all about quarterbacks, right? It's all about if you have a good quarterback, you're a contender. I think we all know that. And now look at what's happened throughout football. He's not even the quarterback in Denver anymore. You know what I mean? He's changing New York Jets history. If Denver doesn't have this Tebow problem because they don't think he can play, they don't go out and sign Peyton Manning and try to change their future. Flynn's not in Seattle. There's probably five or six teams with different quarterbacks right now if Tim Tebow is not the starter, if he doesn't go on that run with Denver last season.
He's Kerry Byrne. I'm Butch Stearns. This has been our Captain Comeback segment here on Cold Hard Football Facts on TPN.